se pone peligrosa como un report. Tapa la calle, mató el amor.
Welcome into Date Palm Field. We've got open-air baseball for you on the show. It's the Colorado Rockies going up against the Cincinnati Reds. First pitch coming your way next. So almost ready to get underway. And on the hill today, Tyler Mahle.
Four-pitch guy, he's got some options to work with in terms of keeping hitters off balance. So we'll see how he decides to utilize those weapons through this start here and whether or not he's able to mix them all in early or if he wants to hold something back a little bit later, maybe second, third time through the order, and give them something they haven't seen. It's tough when you know a guy's got that in his back pocket. As a hitter, you really have to stay on your toes.
And he deals. Charlie Blackmon. Leading off here as he looks at that one outside the zone. Next offering is in for a strike. The pitch. And that's through there for a strike.
The count is one and two.
Left-hand hitter waits. Good eye right there.
I got to count two and two.
Pitch misses there, and the count's full. Kicks and fires. Popped up to the left, into foul ground. One down.
Batting second, the left fielder, number 23, Chris Bryant.
Here's Chris Bryant now. In the air, out towards left center. Puts it away for the out.
Batting third, the third baseman, number 24, Ryan McMahon.
Two outs, bases empty. Ryan McMahon steps to the plate. And when you talk about elite defensive third baseman, this guy is at the top of the list.
Stud. When you look at players like this, you play that hot corner, got to be pretty courageous over there with the way balls come off the bat. That's the kind of guy that every year you expect him to be in the All-Star game and have a gold glove, if not a platinum glove.
Next pitch misses, one and one. No score, just getting started, top of the first. And down on strikes he goes, and that's the third out. Rockies are down quietly. Now it'll be the Reds' turn. No score. It's Major League Baseball, and it's on the show. Bottom of the first. And towing the slab in this one, Herman Marquez. Chris, how about a scouting report?
A power pitcher that is going to pitch aggressively with the fastball. His fastball velocity ranks near the top in the league. He'll also throw the slider, but if you're a hitter, be ready for the fastball. You're going to see a few of them during your at-bat.
Batting second.
Tyler Naquin to the plate.
Tyler Naquin.
In there for strike one. That's a strike.
0-2 count, both pitches on the inside part of the plate. Hitter is thinking, I don't want to get beat here. This is a good time for something off speed away.
On the ground to the left. Base hit. That was smoked through the infield. Lead runner holds up. They're at first and second with nobody out.
Well, that certainly feels good when you can win the at-bat after being down in the count, up against it with two strikes right there. Just a simple ground ball the other way. They've had eyes on it, man. Sometimes it's...
Oh, now this one's high and deep, way back there, on its way, gone. Joey Votto bops one out of here. And just like that, they're out front. It's 3-0.
breaking ball on the inside part of the play requires a hitter to stay really square with his mechanics. If you fly open with the front shoulder, there's no way you keep that ball fair. An outstanding job mechanically. He deserves that home run.
Here's the Reds catcher, Tyler Stevenson.
Batting four. The catcher.
On the ground, Tyler. Right side. And that should be extra bases. Around first, digging for two. And he'll pull in there with a stand-up double.
I'm sure he feels really good about that one. I really like that swing, man. He didn't just push it the other way through the infield. He drove it that way, and it kind of makes me think he was thinking opposite field as he stepped into the box. Got a pitch he liked, and he got it done.
There's a swing and a drive. That one's got a chance. Pulls it in on the warning track. Runner tags at second. Here's Tommy Pham.
The left fielder, Tommy Pham.
That's out to center field. Hilliard sizes this one up. Great effort as he's able to haul it in. And there are two outs. Colin Moran gets a chance to hit here.
Batting seven. The designated hitter, Colin Moran.
Base hit and a run in to score.
Well done. Drives in the run. To me, it's just a really controlled, balanced swing. He wasn't trying to do too much with it. Just stayed disciplined, got the barrel to the ball, and put it in play.
Kyle Farmer up to the plate now. And that one hammered back there. Turning, looking, and that one is gone. He'll touch them all. And they add a couple more. It's 6-0.
A good hitter gets pitch recognition early. He saw exactly where that was going to be. The challenge, not get over anxious and come out of your swing. He stayed on it and got all of it.
Ashton Goodoe takes over on the mound. He's into the game with the bases empty. Now it's Nick Senzel. Out to short on the run. Sends it over to first. And that is that. But the long ball was working in this inning. Not once, but twice. It's now a 6-0 ball game. Second inning set to go. Here's the Rockies cleanup hitter, C.J. Krohn.
The first baseman.
Well, every pitcher wants run support, and having a lead is nice, but it can be challenging for some guys. I think keeping the mindset to attack instead of trying to be too fine and have too much finesse. Go after hitters and get quick outs.
Next offering is in for a strike.
Well, the hitter's got his timing down for the breaking ball. If you're a pitcher, if you can get that fastball in on the hand, it's going to be very difficult for that hitter to get the barrel to it.
And down on strikes, and that's the first out. Now it's Brendan Rodgers.
Well, just excellent location on that inside fastball, really locked him up. And as a hitter, it's not typically what you're looking for. You're trying to protect away and then in, so you can be a little bit tardy with two strikes. Hard to tell if he was fooled or if he thought it would be called a ball, but either way, that's a really nice pitch.
Joe McDonald doing the home plate duties here.
Well, Joe's an interesting one. I'm always trying to figure out what exactly his zone is. Feels like it kind of moves around from game to game, sometimes inning to inning.
The center fielder.
Yeah, the batter now, Sam Hilliard. And first offering is fouled off. But why to kick the pitch? Tap back to the mound. Throw over to Votto. Out number three. 1-2-3 go the Rockies. Still up against a 6-0 deficit. Bottom of the second. Jonathan India at the plate.
Leading off for
and the pitch.
Red. The second baseman. Jonathan.
Lifted in the air right center India. Field. Base hit as he pulls up short.
Didn't take long to get a result for that at bat. I don't know how he's able to shoot that pitch the other way and still put something on it. That pitch was inside, and he let it get really deep. So pretty incredible hands to fight it off and still get good wood on it.
And a base hit up the middle. Throw back in quickly. First and second now with nobody out.
Two consecutive base hits for these guys here. Everything was on time and fluid in that swing. Got a pitch you could get the barrel on and lined it into center for the knock. Those always feel good.
And the batter now is Joey Votto. And there's a fly ball deep right field, way back there. It bangs off the wall. Ball back in quickly. Runner holds at third. The run comes in from second. It's 7-0. The tag, and he's out. Next for Cincinnati, Tyler Stevenson.
The batter, the catcher, Tyler Stevenson.
Swings and blasts one deep to left center. That one back. And it's gone. He'll circle the bases, and they throw a pair on the board. It's 9-0. Singy, the ball is jumping off his bat.
Yes, it is. Tons of loud contact. Man, it's been impressive. You feel like everything goes slow motion when a breaking ball like that leaves the hand right down the middle of the plate, and it's like the pitcher's screaming, "No!" And the hitter saying, "Yes!" And the ball gets tattooed for a big home run.
And the pitch. Pulled hard, but it's a foul ball. The pitch. Stays alive. The wind of the pitch. Foul ball there.
See how the catcher wanted that pitch up and in. Want to try to tie him up. That's the one thing we're seeing, that high fastball. You have to get it up there because of how hitters have changed their swings.
In the air, right side. And he makes the catch. And there's two away.
Now batting.
Two outs, base is empty. Now it's going to be Tommy Pham. That's hard hit in the line. And that is that. But two come across to score in the inning, courtesy of this two-run homer. It's now 9-0. And welcome back, Randall Grichuk now. Malley back to work.
The right fielder.
There's a strike.
Clearly down in this ball game, and you can't look at the deficit and try to get it all back in one swing. It's got to come one at bat at a time, and even shrink it down smaller, pitch to pitch. Make that guy on the mound work to get you out.
0-2 now. Swing and a miss, and he got him. And there's one down.
Really love the pitch sequence right there. I'm telling you what, pitcher and catcher on the same page right now.
Next to hit, Jose Iglesias. And that's in there for strike one. Yeah, the right-hander deals. Swing and a foul back. That's out of play. Got him. Two away now.
Well, I think that's a case of overthinking right there. You got three straight fastballs looking in the 0-2 count just to pour it back.
In the air, left field. Pham settles under it and puts the squeeze on that. And that is that. Nothing doing for the Rockies. Steep hill to climb. It's a 9-0 deficit. Welcome back. Bottom of the inning. Now it's the DH, Colin Moran.
For the Reds.
The wind to the pitch.
The designated hitter, Colin.
Hard ground ball, base knock. And that eats him up.
Well, clearly he was ready to hit right there. Pretty now tough for the infielders to do anything with that one. He pulled it hard into the outfield. And even when you keep it on the ground, it feels great when you hit a missile like that.
Feed to second, that's one. On to Krohn. It's a double play. Two outs, bases empty. And ready to hit now for Cincinnati, Nick Senzel. 0 for 1 so far. And that one lifted in the air center field. Hilliard makes the catch, and that'll do it. On to the fourth. Here's Chuck Nasty. Here comes a pitch.
The designated hitter, Charlie.
And there's a foul ball. Here's your one. Foul ball. The punch out there, and one gone to the fourth as they get the leadoff man.
Oh, there's a three-pitch strikeout. He can do whatever he wants with the baseball
up
right
next
now.
For Colorado,
Chris Bryant will hit next.
Chris Bryant.
Swings through that one. 0-1.
Boog, over 80% of his first pitches are strikes. If you're doing that, you could have a really good day out there on the mound.
Comes up empty on the swing. 0-2 now.
Spin rate's outstanding on that high fastball. Really tough to hit.
Swing and a miss, and he struck him out. Two gone. Two outs, base is empty. Next for Colorado, Ryan McMahon. His first at bat was a strikeout.
McMahon.
And a foul ball. The Rockies still looking for their first hit in this one. Got him! And how about that? It's an immaculate inning.
Well, he's saying, who needs the defense? An immaculate inning, three strikeouts, nine pitches. We just witnessed something really special. Softly, cause you're like the gas tank of a Mr. Softies in the winter. They ain't feeling
you. See, every time you see me, I got. Back here at the ballpark, bottom of the fourth, leading off Jonathan India.
For the red.
The pitch.
The second baseman, Jonathan.
Up the middle, he dives but can't hang on. That's a base hit. No throw, and he reaches safely. Now the number two hitter, Tyler Naquin.
Tyler Naquin.
Rips that one to right. Grichik makes the play, and there's one away. Man at first, Joey Votto, the next to hit for the Reds.
19.
Now fly ball to right center. Hilliard going back on this one. Makes the grab on the run. And there's two away. Tyler Stevenson getting ready to hit. He's already homered here in this one.
Stevenson.
Lined into left center. Base hit.
Oh, this has been a really nice game at the plate for him. He looks locked in. That's a good sound coming off the bat, man. And as he connected out front, lifted into the outfield, that's one of those swings where you just don't even feel the ball hit the barrel. That's a pure stroke.
Right-handed reliever. In the air, center field. Hilliard under it. And that will end the inning. Reds strand a couple, but they still hold a 9-0 lead. Ready now for the fifth inning. So in now for Colorado, C.J. Krohn.
The first baseman, number 25.
That pitch in for a strike. That's strike one.
Krohn.
Kicks and deals. And ball one.
Well, you can't really adjust your game plan for that last pitch. Guy hasn't thrown it very much. You got to focus on the stuff that he's throwing up there most of the time.
That one pushed foul. And a 1-2. And down on strikes he goes. And the leadoff hitter retired in the fifth. Next to hit for the Rockies, Brendan Rodgers. 0-for-1, he struck out swinging last time. And first offering is fouled off. One down, base is empty. Swing and a pop-up. Votto should have this one. Two down.
Good hard fastball up in the zone right there. They look really good coming in, but so hard to get on top of as a hitter.
Center fielder.
Two outs, base is empty. Digging in, it's the speedy outfielder, Sam Hilliard. Grounded out his first time. The Rockies hitless so far in the game. Next offering is fouled back. The 0-2. And that one fouled off.
Now this offense has just been locked down. Almost five full innings of shutout baseball.
And a swing and a miss. And that's that. Rockies are down quietly. And they're down 9-0. Back now to start the bottom of the fifth, and taking over on the mound, Robert Stevenson. He comes in with his team trailing by a bunch, so he'll try to keep it where it is.
Well, at this point in the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and you need a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
Colin Moran digs in now.
The designated hitter, Colin Moran.
Now that's smacked to right center. He can't get there. It's a base hit. Pham around third. Relay throw to second, but he's in there easily.
Back-to-back base hits. A lot of hitters tell themselves, line drive over the infielder's head. That's what I'm trying to do. Just keep that approach simple. And right there, it was perfectly executed. On time with everything. And pulled it.
This one swung on and hit well. Way back there. Onto the warning track. And he hauls it in. Runner tagging for third. He thought about it, but instead returns to second. Nick Senzel, the next to hit for the Reds.
Senzel.
Tapped out in front of the plate. Gets it to first. He's out. Here's the second baseman, Jonathan India.
Number six, second baseman, Jonathan India.
This one high in the air to left center. Bryant settles underneath it and makes the play, and that's out number three. So they pick up a run on two hits, no errors, and a man left. Five innings complete. It's the Reds 10 and the Rockies nothing. Do you think that's just a statement? Then you're ludicrous like it's word of mouth. All set for the top of the sixth. And now the right fielder, Randall Grichuk. Malley back to work. And a strike in there.
I'm impressed by the number of first pitch strikes. He's not afraid of contact. Some guys, they'll nibble just because they don't want to get hit hard. That's not what we're seeing here. And it really looks like these hitters have been in between with their timing today. Good fastball, excellent slider, but they've not been able to commit to one velocity and stay there.
Righty delivers. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Swings through that one. It's a strikeout. So he's gotten deep into this game. And at least so far, not showing a ton of signs of fatigue. Iglesias in the box now. No balls and a strike. The 0-1. Just missed. The Rockies yet to pick up a hit here. Chopped out in front of the plate. Stevenson whips it to first. Two quick outs to open the top of the sixth. Two outs, base is empty. And here is Elias Diaz. And he swings and misses, and it's nothing and one.
Well, on the mound, very efficient, able to produce an outcome, it seems like, within the third or fourth pitch of just about every at-bat.
Swing and a miss, struck him out. And the inning is over. So he's perfect through six. 2-3-4, two up in the home half of the sixth. It's the Reds 10 and the Rockies nothing. And welcome back. John Ciampi with Chris Singleton in the booth and leading off the bottom of the sixth, Tyler Naquin.
The right fielder.
Yeah, the right hander back to work.
Naquin.
Swing and a line drive, base hit out of the center field. Man aboard on the leadoff single.
Now, no waiting around right there. He was ready to swing it on the first pitch. Didn't try to do too much with it. Just a really controlled, simple swing. We don't see a whole lot of that these days with guys trying to launch and hit home runs. But sometimes you got to shorten up just like that.
On a line, base hit. Lead runner to second. So two on and nobody out.
Now batting. The catcher.
And now the catcher comes up to him. Tyler Stevenson for the fourth time tonight. Ground ball left side, could be two. Iglesias to second, on to Crone. It's a double play.
Now batting, the third baseman, Mike Moustakas.
Here's Mike Moustakas to hit. Ground ball right side. Rogers throws to first. Gets him easily, ends the inning. We're through six full. We go to the top of the seventh. Here's Colorado's DH, Charlie Blackman. There's a strike.
You know, he's been so great today. Really just throwing whatever the catcher puts down. I mean, hasn't shaken off the catcher very much at all today.
Next offering is in for a strike. Righty to the plate. Cut on and miss. Struck him out. And one gone.
Dominating strikeout there on just three pitches, and that's what a good power pitcher can do to you. He's hitting the spots, filling up the strike zone. Sometimes he bats over before it really begins.
Now the Reds manager is out of the dugout and will make a move to the pen. Tyler Malley is done, and as he heads for the dugout, we'll take a quick break. New arm on the mound when we get back. Pitching change here, Tony Santion. And he's got a nice lead to work with. Bryant at the plate for the third time as he comes up empty there. The 0-1. And he chases a high fastball there. And a pitch. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. That's out number two. Two outs. Base is empty. Here's the third baseman, Ryan McMahon.
To Colorado, the third baseman.
And the first pitch misses for ball one.
That's where you want it. It's a good miss.
Swing and a ball lifted left field. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. Welcome back. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Now the left fielder, Tommy Pham.
For the Reds, the left fielder.
And a pitch.
Pham.
And that's a base hit. So a man on base to start the inning.
First pitch swing in, went up there with a plan to be aggressive. Now I could watch base hits like that one all day long, and so could every hitting coach in the league. Just a nice line drive into center field.
Iglesias, that's one. A sensational double play. Plenty of offense to this one, Singy. I guess you'd say kind of what we expected, though.
Well, this was a game, looking at the pitching matchup, where you expected offense to score, and not as lopsided as this. But, yeah, you definitely expected to see some offense coming up.
McMahon fires over to first. Third out. We go to the eighth. Here's the Rockies cleanup hitter, C.J. Cron.
The first baseman, number 25.
In for a strike. It's 0-1. The pitch. And it's fouled away. A wind in the pitch. Swing and a miss, and he is down on strikes for the third straight at bat.
Well, they've had a great plan of attack for him tonight. I mean, finding all the holes in his swing and his approach, just frustrating for him up there. You strike out a guy three times in a game, I think that guy's got to go back and really study some video with his hitting coach, figure out how they're beating him, make this adjustment really quick, because word will get around the league in a hurry.
And here is Brendan Rodgers. And he deals. In the air, out towards right center. Senzel, long run, in there, base hit. And the bid for history is gone. And into second with one away, that's a double. So up next, Sam Hillier.
Sam Hillier.
Check swing, but he went too far. Strike one. Runner leads away at second. Strike two.
Well, it looks like he just got out of himself a little bit right there. He's looking for a ball in, and to attack that pitch looked like a half-hearted swing.
Swing and a miss, struck him out. Now two out. Randall Grichuk, the next to hit.
Just a mid-90s challenge fastball right there, not much to it. And I'm sure he'd love another swing at it because it was in a very hittable location. Those are the swings where you can sometimes start to question yourself as a hitter and say, how did I miss that? But you know what happens.
Swings and misses, and that'll do it. So one left for Colorado. They're down 10-0. Back here at the ballpark, and now Nick Senzel.
Leading off for the Reds, the center fielder, Nick Senzel.
And the pitch. Ground ball up the middle. Sends it to first. Leadoff man is out here in the eighth. Now it's the second baseman, Jonathan India.
Second baseman, Jonathan India.
On the ground, right side. That's a base hit. So a man aboard now with one away. Now here is Tyler Naquin.
Number 12, Tyler Naquin.
Diaz drifts towards it and puts the squeeze on that one. Two down.
Boy, that was a hanging breaking ball right there. I think he tried to do a little bit too much. Sometimes those eyes can get really big. I think his swing broke down as well, and that's what caused him to pop it up.
Man at first, in now for the Reds, Joey Votto. Ripped on a line to center. Racing, makes the catch. And that ends the inning. Reds leave one, but they still hold a 10-0 lead. And welcome back. Here's the shortstop at the plate, Jose Iglesias.
The shortstop, Jose Iglesias.
Santion back to work. And there's a ball. And there's a strike on the outside corner.
If you're not ready for that pitch, you're just going to swing and miss or pop it up, waste the at bat. You're going to let it go. You better be ready to swing it.
Right-hander kicks, deals. Got him looking. Down on strikes, and he knew it. And now it's Elias Diaz.
No, just couldn't pull the trigger on the fastball right there, and I don't think he was taking it, thinking it might be a called ball or anything. I just think he was flat-out frozen. Did not expect that location, in my opinion.
The 0-1. There's the strike at the knees. Got him. Two away.
Well, he froze him with the changeup right there, and I think he was so geared up for fastball. Once he recognized that it was off speed, he just wasn't able to make an adjustment. So a really good strikeout, and pitcher just won the battle.
So the batting order turns over. Here's Charlie Blackman. That one's in there, 0-1. Just one strike away. Popped up, foul territory behind the plate. And he makes the catch. Ball game. And the Reds slug their way to a win in this one.
Well, his team was ready from the first pitch of the ball game. Swinging the bats, scoring runs, just very aggressive. I feel like they set the tone, and that tone created a momentum that took them all the way to the finish line. Nice win today.
10-0, your final in this one. For Chris Singleton and our entire crew, I'm John Shambi saying so long.
The final line score for our ball game tonight for the victorious Cincinnati Reds, 10 runs, 9.